You guys all came here tonight. You think that there's a show. Well, there isn't. I have the money. I have the money, and believe it. All the guys in Fort Kent went back. They're all fighting. They say they're never coming to Van Buren again. I did that. All of that I did. I started it all. I'm so darn proud of myself. I did everything. Unless something goes wrong. I have all this money.
And I will be your interlocutor for the evening. The purpose of this evening is to have some fun, both for you and for us. Last year, we were invited to Van Buren by the Chamber of Commerce, and we had a great time. I think the show lasted 3.5 hours. We don't plan to keep you here this long tonight. Our show should last 2 hours, more or less, depending on how long you laugh. So if you want to go home early, don't laugh. We would like to thank the Gateway Snowmobile Club for inviting us. It's a great way to create friendship between our two communities. We get to know you, and you get to know who we are. The Snowmobile Club provided us with a delicious lunch before the show. We thank them very much, especially the ladies who prepared it. We are doing basically the same show we did in Fort Kent 1 month ago. Those of you who saw it will see it again. As a matter of fact, we sold about 200 tickets to Van Buren people for our Fort Kent show. So you can see that we already like each other. We hope that nothing we say or do will offend anyone. If we mention your name during the show, it is not our fault. Look to your friends who have told us to talk about you. We are not professionals and we will make mistakes, but I think we can all laugh together when that happens. In any case, we're glad to be here. Let's start the show by introducing the end beasts. The first one to step out is our chief of police in Fort Kent, Dudy Michaud. Come on out, dude.
Miles. I said, Scott, I said, you're not going to sell that pickup with 190,000 miles. He said, yeah, but it goes good. I met him today when we came here. He was still driving his pickup and there was no sign in it. He said, I'm not selling your pickup anymore, Scott. He said, no, it only got 11,000 miles now.
That's our chief of police. Did you notice his left ear? Turn around, dude, and show them over there. Yeah. He doesn't know which side is which. Our next end beast is the strongest man in Fort Kent. His name is Mo Ryu.
Talk about strong men. Not too long ago, one of my friends, Benanzi, you know Benan? From Jim Gerard, from Madagascar, and myself, we were at the yacht club, we were having a Pepsi. And we started an argument, the three of us. Benanzi says the people from Van Buren are the strongest people in the valley. Jim Gerard, he said the same thing too. I say for Fort Kent, we're the strongest people. So I says, we prove it to you. So I go in my pickup and I go get a hammer. I says to Benanzi, you swing that hammer just as far as you can. And the one that swing the hammer the furthest, he's the one that's going to be the strongest. So Benanzi grabbed that hammer, he swung that around his head 3 or 4 times. He didn't let that sucker go, and by the 150 feet. Holy crap, Benanzi, you're a strong man for sure. What you guys doing here in Van Buren anyway? Oh, he said, my great-grandfather, he was a farmer. My grandfather, he was a farmer too. My father, he was a farmer, and my brothers, the two brothers, they're farmers, and me, I'm a farmer too. A farmer, he has to be strong and he has to be rugged. And made a lot of sense. So, show it no matter what's called, he didn't get on. When you forget his name, so that means Monsieur or Madame. You know, he grabbed the hammer, you know, and he swing that around his head 4 or 5 times, and that sucker, she goes to, and she goes 200 feet. Holy Christ, he says, what you do, you guys, no matter what's going on? Well, he says,
My great-grandfather, he worked at the mill. My father, he worked at the mill, and my three brothers, they work at the mill, and I work at the mill, too. And you got to be strong, he says, to take those leaves of papers and take them all over the place. This is, that's why, he says, you're big and strong. So I take the hammer. I take the hammer and I swing that, you know, 4, 5, 6, 7 times. I light that door and I go 500 feet. Oh, the boy, you strong man, you poor cat. This is what you guys do. It's my great grandfather, he was on welfare. My grandfather, he was on welfare. My father, him too, is on welfare. I got three brothers, they are all on welfare. And me too, I'm on welfare. My father, he told me, he said, son, when I was young, if somebody ever gives you a hammer, you swing that sucker as hard as you can.
From Limestone, which is not very far from here, we have a poet, Dave Potter. Here he comes. You think that's going to work?
Yes.
Oh, what a difference.
There once was a man with a hernia who said to his surgeon, gosh darn ya, when fixing my mill, be sure and don't fiddle with items that do not concern you.
Representative Judy Paradis in the front row. We're going to use that at the Democratic Convention there. From Sandigat, seat B. He's got rocks in his head, but here he comes.
So, all right?
Why, extended the rock?
Yes, you know, I live in the big city, you know. I see these people, they walk in the street with the big, big radio. So I ask them, I say, well, you do that radio? He said, I listen to music, rock music, so I make my own music.
Come on up there. Where's your friend Spit?
Gee, I don't see him in a long time.
Well, he must be around. Where is he?
you look different.
How you doing?
I do all right.
Long time no see, huh?
Long time. Last time I saw you, gee, many.
No, last year. Yeah, well, that's when we used to play cards there every Saturday night.
Yeah, we used to play cards all the time, me and you.
Yeah, and after a while I got a card. Yeah, it was all the going to your house.
Right, you never invite me over.
Yeah, but I just live across the lake.
Yeah, but how do I go there?
Yeah, but your wife there, she told me you bought a new canoe.
Yeah, nobody told me I had to buy paddles for that.
Yeah, man. How about the new boat you bought?
Nobody told me I had to buy a motor.
Well, look, I think I can fix that. This week, this Saturday night, you come over to my place across the lake.
How do I go there?
All I have to do is, I got my new black pickup now. I'm gonna park that next to the water at night. Face that toward your house and turn on the light. It's gonna make a nice big beep across the lake, y'all. You just walk across.
You think I'm stupid, you? I go halfway across the lake and you cut the lights out.
Okay, the Lions are going to come out as a group here. We're going to little sing a little song. As the lions come roaring along.
Thank you.
You know, my father was 80 years old last month, and that's a fact. And he's always been a good friend to me. I've always respected him and sought his advice. Years ago, when I was a young man, he told me all about the facts of life. One day we were working in the shed, and he asked me if I knew anything about the VD. I said, "Dad, I'm only 27 years old. How should I know anything about that?" Well, he said, "Son, VD is spread by flies. Make sure you keep yours shut." Now to perform for you the music of P.D.Q. Bach. Please welcome from the UMFK Musical Theater, Professor Scott T. Owl, Gary Ann, and Diane Sosie Netto Sosie, who will accompany them.
Thank you.
favorites in the trap. Hey, mister! Aren't you cold?
Oh, I'm freezing.
Then why are you sitting there just in your trousers?
That's my wife's idea. I came out here yesterday without a shirt on and I got a stiff neck.
Puis en avant du petit gars, il y avait une femme qui était nurse, qui était habillée, elle était bien, hein, ouais. Elle était grosse, c'est une témère qui était grosse. Il y avait partout. Le petit gars, il avait peur à peu près comme 7-8 ans. Il regardait ça, puis il n'avait jamais vu une grosse femme de même. Il avait l'air pas trop swift non plus. Il adore ça, puis plutôt il se vient de voir, puis il a son père. Ah, oh, as-tu vu la grosse femme, hein? Oh, pas, oh, grosse, hein? Oh, hein? Bonhomme, il fait sa tête, le petit gars, puis il dit, hey, coudon, tais-toi, il dit, elle va t'attendre, puis il dit, elle va t'être embarrassée. Le petit gars, il se rabaudit, puis il commence à la tour dans le dos, puis il dit, pas, as-tu vu, tu pas comme t'as des gros jambes, hein? Oh, pas, oh, t'as des gros jambes. Tais-toi. Tout d'un coup, elle avait un beeper, hein. Tout d'un coup, ça sonne, ils ont fait besoin de l'hôpital. Après, ça donne bip, bip, bip. Il dit, pas toi des jambes à la queue.
Cette chanson à Wing a Hand.
Yeah.
I see it.
Yeah, but you look close, you. You can hear real good with it.
You really good with that?
I don't got too much either.
What kind is it?
It's 2:30.
He said,
don't do that, my boy. That's not right. You have to give you a big penance for that. I say, yeah, but I have to confess myself 110 times for getting my mother back. He said, why? Well, I said, well, I don't touch it, and it'd go all over the wall. At the confession. You know, I've been going to confession since then, and I'm still on the first edit.
So far, you haven't seen any real talent, right? We do the best we can, but we do have some real talent at Fort Kent. By the name of Chuck Clauser. He'll come out here and sing you a little song.
Well, I mean, what is it that causes this to occur?
Well, that's because I'm a Martian.
You're a Martian? Who can tell me about this? A Martian?
Well, yes. I'm from Mars.
You're from Mars?
Yes.
Yeah.
You well, know, we're really interested about what happened on Earth here.
You are?
Yeah. What do you guys have for breakfast?
Well, for breakfast? Well, let's see. Well, we have cereal. We could have bacon and eggs. Yeah, that's the sort of thing we have. Well, what do you have on Mars?
We have pills.
Pills.
Yeah.
Pills.
What do you guys have for lunch?
For lunch? Well, let's see. Lunch. Oh, well, we could have croutons. We could have chicken stew. We could things like that. What do you have?
We have pills.
You have pills?
Yes.
Pills.
What do you guys have for dinner?
For dinner? Well, my goodness, we could have any spaghetti. We could have any number of things. What do you people have?
We have pills.
You have pills?
Yes.
My goodness.
What do you guys give to your mental patients?
Well, why we give them pills? What do you do?
We walk them.
By the way, that's our organist, Diane Nedosocia from Fort Kent. That the guy with the spotlight there is doing a great job. We just met half an hour ago. I think his name is Gilles Gauvin. And the one on stage, or maybe it's vice versa, his name is Marcel Gagnon. I'd like you to give him a... And again, just before we got here, we met the two guys on sound. So far, they haven't made a mistake. Been real good, and that's Doug Dumont and Todd Willett. Huh? Now, Mark Michaud, you've seen him last year. I think he was a Seguin here last year. Now he's a Bûcheron. He'll tell you a few stories.
Me again. hey, me, I cut wood, but right now I pull on the penny. hey, in the woods there in the winter, we have fun, we have two, only bunch of men in the wood in the camps. The cookie, he played trick on us, him all the time. One day, he tells that the guy there, he says, hey, you know what? You know what? What that be? Says, Easter. Then one guy, he says, oh, me, I know Easter. I know what that is. Oh, Easter. He says, that way my mother, there, she bake a big turkey, and everybody come home there, and he, that's not Easter, that Thanksgiving. Easter. Now I know what Easter be now. Yeah. Easter, that's when big guy dress up, you know, a big white beard. He come give little kids presents. Yes, I mean, that's not Easter, that's Christmas. he did, they take him down, they put him in a hole in the ground, and then 3 days later, they put a big rock there, and 3 days later he come out, and if he see a shadow there, winter time.
I cheat. I don't want to hear that word cheat no more. He says, when you do that, he says, say I fall. So it comes and the women come in and they confess, they say I fall with this one and I fall with that one. But this old priest, he died. And this young priest, he come and take his place. Well, this young priest, he come in the confession and he listen, the women, I fall with this one, and I fall with that one. After a couple of weeks, he did not know what had happened. He goes downtown and he sees the town manager. He said, the town manager, you're going to have to fix the streets. He said, the people, she fall all over the place. The town manager, he knew what was going on because it had been going on with the old priest. He started laughing. The priest looked at him and he said, you should not laugh. Your wife, she fall 4 times last month.
In Fort Kent, we have the new kids on the block. In Van Buren, it's the old kids on the block. Here they come.
Ah.
18 kids, only how many? What do you do about that?
I want you to dump the train on a nightclub. Hey, come on, forget about synectomy.
$300. Wow.
Yeah, it costs too much. So, I went to Fort Kent. But Dr. Johnson, he can do it for 1995.
1995. Good deal. Yeah. How did you do that?
Well, he told me to take a firecracker, roll up a piece of paper, and put the firecracker in there. And light it and count to 10.
Oh?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I'll be 200 of them running around in a month.
for a
go back a long ways, right?
guy that delivered me took one look at me, flipped me over, and said, "Hey, twins." Then he goes out and tells my old man we did the best we could, but he pulled through. Hey, we were really poor in my neighborhood. The rainbows were in black and white. So poor the neighbors had me. That's bad. For my birthday, my old man showed Dimmy a picture of a birthday cake. Almost got a hernia trying to blow out the candles. Even my mother didn't like me too well. She fed me with a slingshot. Got no respect from anybody, right? Then I got a little bit older, I started dating this girl, right? I was fighting about money and sex, right? I kept thinking she was charging me too much. She called me up and said, "Hey, come on over, nobody's home." I'd go over, nobody was home. I'll tell you, I did something really dumb. I married her. Talk about a cook. At my place, we pray after we eat. Hey, I got the only dog in the world that begs for Alka-Seltzers. That's bad, eh? The other night she says, "Hey, take the garbage out." I said, "Hey, you cooked it, you take it out, eh?" She's kind of weird, too. You know, she's got weird sex habits. She likes to talk when she's having sex. The other night she called me from the motel. Yeah. She also likes to do it in the back seat. The only problem is she wants me to drive. You think that's wrong, eh? I'll tell you. She couldn't pass a driver's test. She couldn't get used to sitting in the front seat. Yeah. Kind of weird, yeah. The other day I came home early from work, right? This guy jogging in the nude. I said, "Hey, fella, what are you doing that for?" He said, "Because you came home early." Yeah, right? I should have known something was wrong. For about 3 weeks now, I come home and a pair of yells, "Quick, out the back door." Yeah. Did you get that one? No, I didn't either. I get no respect from anybody, right? I figured when I'd have kids, it would seem to change, right? I got this boy, right? I bought him a BB gun for his birthday. He bought me a t-shirt with a big bullseye on it. Yeah, I mean, I told about the birds and the bees. He told me about the old lady and the milkman. I even had a hooker one time turn me down. She said she had a headache. Anything like that, huh? Yeah, think that's bad? My bartender. You're supposed to get respect for your bartender, right? Right? I go in there and say, "Hey," he said, "what do you have?" I said, "Surprise me. You showed me a new picture of my wife." I'll say, I'm getting respect for anybody. I'll say it, Jeff.
Well, I'll have to tell you about a lot of people from Maine go to Florida in the winter, you know. Some of them retire there, some of them last a long time. One guy from Fort Kent, he was 96 years old. And he went to a senior citizens party, met an 88-year-old lady. And gee, he liked her right off. They danced all night, had a great time. Next night he said, "I'm going to invite her to have dinner with me," so they went for some chicken wings somewhere. He liked her so much, he said, "I'd like to propose matrimony to you." He said, "You know, I'm well off, we can do a lot of traveling, and you won't have to ask for nothing the rest of your life." She said, "Well, that's fine, but how about sex?" Well, he said, "Infrequent." She said, "Is that one word or two?" I'm telling you, I was alone up here. I had to do that. Joe Pinette goes to see Dr. Chang. Let's see what happens.
Tell me, Mike, what do you have?
I got the shingles.
I have a seat?
Yeah, have a seat.
Right here?
Yeah, that's fine. We'll check your heartbeat here. Mike, do you have Blue Cross Blue Shield?
Yeah. No, I don't have Blue Cross. I got a piece of the rock.
I got
the
shingles.
Yeah, but Doc, I get the shingles, you know.
Now, Mike, have you had any surgery recently?
I had a vasectomy.
How'd it go?
Went off without a bang.
Okay, Mike, what do you weigh?
What do I weigh? Doc, I got the shingles.
What do you weigh? What do you weigh?
150.
Okay. Check your blood
pressure.
Kijk hoe jij dus dat ding niet doet neer. Als hier dat in een Française, dan zei hij dat marche plus en Français. Je suis une trompe, chose de même, pour dire ça en anglais. Puis si je commence à parler tout seul, là, c'est le même moment d'aller, ok? À peu près le mois de février, ma femme et puis moi, on était gardés sur une des garçons qui était en vacances. Ont dû quitter. Mais ça fait 8 heures dans veillée, ça, le samedi. La petite a sous, évidemment, t'en broyait. Une petite goutte d'essence sur le bord de la lèvre, elle avait une petite dent, elle avait une petite dent. Elle pensait que ça bouge, ma mère se faisait tout, je lui ai dit, je lui ai dit, hey, écoute, c'est normal, ça. C'est quand on arrive à cet âge-là, on perd nos bébés, tu sais, puis il y en a d'autres qui viennent. Quand tu viens un petit peu plus vieux, tu as une cinquantaine d'années, tu perds ses loto. Puis tu vas sur le dentiste, puis il y en a un autre, on a ça. Hein? Ça se fait, je dis, prends ta dame, puis mets-la en dessous de rien. Puis la tooth fairy, là, elle va venir, là, puis elle va mettre 5 piastres en dessous de ton rien. Elle va enlever la dame. T'as deux temps, là, c'était 25 cents, hein? Mais c'est en chambre, je suis c'est 5 piastres, mais franchement, là, moi, je vais monter avec les 5 piastres parce que je vieillis, hein. Puis je vais aller au ciel, ça se fait François. Avec ma tassette, ma mère, tu vas pas loin. Le jour de soir, là, après que la petite était couchée, j'ai tendu une secousse, puis j'ai été dans sa chambre. J'ai enlevé la dent, puis j'ai mis. Il y a 5 piastres en dessous de sonnerier, puis je suis sorti, puis je m'en étais. Je pensais que la petite, elle dormait, mais la petite colline, elle dormait pas, elle a plus du sommeil, monsieur. Toujours, là, au matin, après qu'elle se réveille, elle doit sortir 5 piastres, oh, le bois, c'était le moyen d'en faire. Elle s'habille, puis elle s'en va dans le voisinage, hein, ça commence à dire à toutes ses petites amies, là. Je sais quelque chose, moi, je sais quelque chose, moi, vous savez pas, vous autres. Je sais quelque chose, vous autres, moi, vous savez pas, vous autres. Je les autres, et on dit, ben, pour l'amour, vous savez, tu sais. Elle dit, mon papa, il est un père.
Going, isn't it?
while ago you saw some real talent from Fort Kent. You're going to see it again. Let's welcome George Jell.
You know what's really, really gross?
Oh, what's really, really gross?
Can't you open the fridge up? Is rubber roast pet?
Christmas tree we can make no money.
No, you couldn't buy no shirt, huh?
No.
That was sold a lot of trees, though, huh?
Yeah, but we made no money.
Yeah, well, we sold all those trees. It cost us $3.
And we sell them for $3, too.
Well, my boy.
What do we do now?
I don't know. What could we do to make more money?
Buy a bigger truck?
Yeah.
From La Beauce again, we have La Belgique, who will come out and show us a few steps. Where is she? You've got the light of a bird, eh? Now, La Belgique, avant que vous allez faire une petite chanson, une danse pour nous autres, j'aimerais... Avez-vous l'histoire de compter? Comment est-ce que votre voyage était de la Beauce?
Oh, je suis bien exhausté, mon voyage.
Vous êtes exhausté?
Oh, exhausté.
C'est qu'arrivé.
J'ai descendu sur l'autobus. Ah. J'étais assis de fenêtre pour vous aider. Il manque
la... Bon.
Ça a remonté, ça. Ça a vibré mon corps de trois pistoles à l'église. J'ai été au modèle de la soirée, je me suis couché. Je pensais à ça, ce moteur-là, comment ça grondait quand ça montait les côtes puis ça descendait. Ça me faisait pour deux. Je me suis endormi. J'ai rêvé toute la nuit au muffler. Un matin, quand je me suis réveillé, j'étais assez exhausté.
J'espère que vous êtes pas assez exhausté pour nous danser. Jig.
Ah, ben,
j'en sors
tout le temps un petit peu. En avant de la musique, mon dog. Envoyez ça.
C'est mon cousin.
sont venus à 30 000 ans. Il y a un petit gars qui était sur sa gloire, puis il watchait. Il trouvait ça curieux. Mais toi, il dit, « Mister Labate, I don't want to bother you too much, but do you know, he says, that your music is stopped and your monkey is burning?
Another poem for us.
There was a young woman named Annie with erogenous zones in each cranny. She learned this was so with the help of her beau, who explored her from forehead to fanny.
Again, some real talent. George Monk, sa femme. Il y a le voir le docteur, M. George Moss s'est fait examiner la semaine passée, là. Là, il y a le voir pour le résultat de ça, c'est des tests-là. What's wrong with poor Joe? We're going to meet the doctor first. That's the nurse.
Il était couché. Il y a deux heures d'envie, il était psss. Ça may have spirit. Sometimes they have a name.
Shh! C'est vrai! C'est Joe!
Mon Dieu! Ça fait 6 mois que je me fais ça premièrement. Ben, ça prend du temps de bien processer les dents blancs. Ça fait du temps. Dis, qu'est-ce que tu fais? C'est-tu beau? Il y a quelque chose après ça? C'est-tu beau? Qu'est-ce que vous faisiez? Ben, je vais te dire. Le matin, dis, quand on se lève la première appel, ils ont fait un petit peu d'amour. Puis, dis, vers les 9h, tout à fait déjeuner, vers 9h, 9h30, ils ont fait encore un petit peu d'amour. Puis, dis, midi, tout après dîner, ben, c'est tout de suite, c'est l'amour. Et là, tout après-midi, il appelle ça un nooner. Tout après souper, il va être encore un petit peu d'amour. Puis quand on se repose, on prend un siesta. Puis il va se faire vers 9h, vers un coup, on prend un petit peu d'amour. Puis il dit, ça fait une journée. Il dit, mon nous, il dit, tu prends des dossiers? T'es au ciel? Non, non, non. Il dit, je suis un dieu, mais le ciel, il m'a pris.
Well, they said they like a mink in the closet, a cougar in the garage, a tiger in the bedroom, and a jackass to pay the bills. For all of you people who watch Hee Haw on Saturday night, it's picking and grinning time.
Pick a lot of potatoes.
get when you cross an elephant with a prostitute?
Oh, I'd like to see that. I don't know.
I have ton pickup.
Very skinny paratrooper.
I don't know.
Gone with the wind. Direction, but for him, it's always nature and God. Last summer, he was doing the Allagash, and he left the river and he took a hike in the woods. And while he was out in the woods, he met a bear. The bear was quite ferocious, and he turned around, and Father Marti is supposed to be 80 years old, and the bear started to chase him. So Father Marti started to run, and he wouldn't run into too fast, and he says, right away he thought of God. He says, oh God, please, he says, help me, God, make my legs real light so I can run away from the bear. And he looked, and the bear was coming pretty close to him, and he says, oh God, come on, please help me. And he says, yes, help me. And the bear was real close, and then he looked up to heaven, and he says, look, God, if you don't want to help me, don't help the bear.
Get older. Three things, really. The first one is that you lose your memory. The other two, I don't remember. All the way from New York, the platters.
Oh.
phrase. Oh, here comes our poet.
Did you hear about the time Mark walked into the yacht club? And he looked at the bar and he saw three animals sitting there. There was, and he was so surprised. But I didn't know there were animals in here. So he walks up and looks. There's a skunk, a deer, and a giraffe. And he says, which one of you is buying? Well, the skunk looks at him and says, I don't have a cent. And the deer looks at him and says, I haven't had any dough since last fall. So the giraffe looks at him and says, well, fellas, I guess the high ball's around me.
Hi, there. You put Greyhound Strike out of Van Buren, huh? So we're going to go for a bus ride. Here's the bus driver right now.
Yes, no, yes, no, yes.
go back to the 50s again. This time the coasters with yakety yak.
Instead of the cod liver oil and the spinach.
Right here, Father. We're going now to Joe's bar. Remember Jackie Gleason?
Yeah.
He used to say, "Hi, Mr. Donahue." Or Donahue? Then he'd take out a magazine, magazine. We've got one here right now. It says, "What not to name your dog." Everybody who has a dog calls him Rover or Fido. I call my dog Six. Now, Six has been very embarrassing to me. When I went to City Hall to renew his dog license, I told the clerk I would like to have a license for Sex. He said, "I'd like to have one too." Then I said, "But this is a dog." He said he didn't care what you looked like. Then I said, "You don't understand. I've had Sex since I was 9 years old." Said, "You must have been quite a kid." When I got married, I went on my honeymoon. I took the dog with us. I told the clerk that I wanted a room for my wife and me, and a special room for Sex. He said that every room was for Sex. I said, "You don't understand. Sex keeps me awake at night." He said, "Me too." Then When my wife and I separated, we went to court to fight for custody of the dog. Your Honor, I had sex before I was married. The judge said, no. Then I told him that after I was married, sex left me. He said, me too. Last night, sex ran away again. I spent hours looking around town for him. A cop came over to me and asked, what are you doing in this alley at 4 o'clock in the morning? I said, I'm looking for sex. Going to court Friday.
Bye. because she began to sing. I'm having trouble with my car. The muffler is falling apart. It's making a lot of noise. I gotta go downtown and make some shopping, and I need the car. Steve says, sorry, dear, I cannot leave. I'm busy at the store. I cannot go.
Voice, why don't you sing us a song tonight, huh? Before we leave here, come on.